Hello everyone, in this video we'll discuss parametrization of the unit circle. And the important thing that we will look at rational parametrization, which is very important for us. Let me firstly remind you what parametrization means for arbitrary curve. For example, you have some curve, whatever it can be, and parametrization, this is in fact construction, a correspondence between numbers and each point on a curve. So imagine that we have here a line of numbers and we want to take any point on a curve and find a number corresponding to this point. We kind of number each point on a curve. And of course, the correspondence must be one-to-one. So it means that for each point on a curve, we find a number, and for each number, we find its point on a curve. So we must do this on a unit circle. So we take a unit circle with radius 1, with the equation x squared plus y squared is 1. And we must to write a correspondence between a point on a unit circle and a point on some number line. We call it, let's say, t. So we must find this correspondence. And the idea how to find this correspondence is the following. We look at this y-axis and we call, let this y-axis be this t line. And we choose the point here, particular point on the circle, with coordinates minus 1, 0. And for each point here on this line, let's say we took this point with coordinates 0, t, we draw a line through this point and this point. We draw a line and we find intersection of this line with the circle. So let me remove this part here. Okay, and this point here will be that point which corresponds to our t. So in fact, if you go along this line changing t, you will see that this point goes along the circle. Let me show you this in application. So you see, we took the point minus 1, 0, and for arbitrary t, we draw this line and another intersection point with the circle, we denote e of t. And you see, as we change t, this t moves along the line, the y-axis, e of t moves along the circle. So indeed, we constructed the correspondence between numbers and points on a circle. The one problem appears here. If you want to get the correspondence for minus 1, 0 for this particular point, so the corresponding point will be the point in some sense at infinity. So you see, as larger you go along this line, as this point is closer to this point minus 1, 0. So it's not possible to get to this minus 1, 0. So this is kind of correspondence between minus 1, 0 and infinity point on this line of numbers. Okay, and now the problem is to find this e of t. So let's come back and let's try to find this point e of t. So the first thing that we do, we find the equation of a line which goes through the points minus 1, 0 and 0, t. So let's do this. We take the point 1, minus 1, 0 times the point 1, 0, t to get a line. So we obtain a line minus t, and the last one is just 1. So the equation of this line is minus t times x plus y is 0. Okay, and now the second step, we need to find intersection of the line with the circle. So we have to solve the system minus t y, x, minus t x minus plus y is 0, and x squared plus y squared is 1, which is the equation of the circle. And t here is a parameter, so we need to get rid of x and y to find x and y in terms of t. So let's solve this system. From the first equation, we know that y is equal to t, 1 plus x, and let's substitute it into the second equation. So we get x squared plus t squared and 1 plus x squared, so this is 1 plus 2x plus x squared, which is 1. And if we rewrite it now as a quadratic equation, we get x squared with the coefficient t squared plus 1 plus 2t squared x and plus t squared minus 1 equals 0. So we get this quadratic equation. And to solve it, we use the formula. So this is minus b, so 2 t squared with minus plus minus square root of 4t to the 4 minus 4t squared plus 1t squared minus 1 over 2t squared plus 1. So we can cancel 2 and we get minus t squared plus minus. Here you see 40 to the 4 and minus 40 to the 4 will disappear, and the only thing which is left, just 4. Square root of 4 is 2 and cancelled again, so it's just 1. And here t squared plus 1. And you can notice that 1 root here is definitely this point, minus 1, 0, so this one. So the first root here is minus 1, and the second root here is 1 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared. So the first root will get minus 1 when we choose minus sign here, and the second root when you choose plus sign here. So this will be our x coordinate of parametrization. And let's find the y coordinate using this thing here. Y is t times 1 plus x. So y is t times 1 plus x. And x we already found, this is 1 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared. So what is left, just calculate this thing here. So t times the fraction 1 plus t squared, 1 minus t squared will be just 2. So this is 2t, 1 plus t squared. So our parametrization of the circle is e of t, which has the coordinates 1 minus t squared, the x coordinate, and 2t, 1 plus t squared. So this is the parametrization of the unit circle.